I'm Elizabeth Nogrady, the coordinator of academic programs at the Francis Lehman Loeb Arts Center, and I'm speaking to Ronald Patkus, head of special collections. Ron, my first question is, the exhibition Imperial Augsburg includes works from the German Renaissance, spanning in date from around 1475 to 1450. How common were books in Germany in this period? What types of books were being produced, and who had access to them?
In our digital age, it's sometimes difficult for us to understand and grasp the revolution in printing that took place in the 15th century. But already by the year 1500, scholars estimate that between 15 and 20 million books had been printed. There was a real revolution at that time. With this said, most of the books that were printed at the time were religious in nature. As the years went by, more and more topics were covered. And certainly in the 16th century, printing continued to spread across Europe, especially with important historical events such as the Reformation.
How were books made at this time in Augsburg and other German cities? Did innovations in printing during the German Renaissance affect how information was exchanged?
The way books were made at this time, that is in the late 15th and early 16th century, was still dependent on the technology brought to us by Johannes Gutenberg. His first book was printed around 1455. It relied on a wooden press and also movable type. That same technology persisted actually for hundreds of years. With that said, as you mentioned, there were also other innovations that took place at various times. And some of these did affect how information could be exchanged. We think, for instance, in the early 16th century of the Reformation, when small leaflets came to be printed and could be rapidly distributed among the population, thus allowing a particular topic to be spread at great rate due to printing.
How did book printing in Germany compare to other parts of Europe at this time?
So printing began in Germany, in Mainz, where Gutenberg lived. And slowly, after his invention in the 1450s, it began to spread to other towns along the Rhine and other German-speaking cities. Eventually, printing enters Italy in the 1460s, and it becomes very important in this land where the Renaissance was in full bloom. Venice actually emerges as a very important site by the end of the 15th century. Eventually, printing does spread to other parts of Europe, though, and England as well. England, though, is about a generation behind other parts of Europe. And it's only later, of course, that printing will spread to America and the New World.
Many of the works in the exhibition contain a mix of text and images. Was this format a challenge for printmakers?
For hundreds of years, text and images had been combined in medieval manuscripts. As we enter the period of printing, the way of doing that was still a challenge, and each printer had to figure out how that challenge would be met as they printed a particular book. It's in this context that it's especially interesting to look at the Nuremberg Chronicle, which contains nearly 2,000 woodcuts. And each page had to be laid out individually so that when the work was finally printed, they would know exactly how it would look. An amazing accomplishment.